Meaty was making meal of me. This is the guy. This is the guy who's responsible for rolling up the agents in Moscow. And for the KGB, they had a decoy to cover the real asset inside the agency.
Ed Howard claims he's the scapegoat and Aldrich Ames the mole. Ames, a longtime CIA spy, was exposed last year as a double agent on the KGB payroll for a decade. Ames pleaded guilty to espionage and is now serving a life sentence. In 1985, as the FBI was building its case against Howard, then living in New Mexico, Ames's treachery had not yet been uncovered. So when the CIA's Moscow station was suddenly ravaged by leaks and its undercover Soviet agents started disappearing off the street, Howard says he was the fall guy. Somebody was talking to the KGB. Howard says it was not him, but he didn't stick around to make his case. As the FBI closed in, Howard disappeared from Santa Fe and showed up 4 days later in the Soviet Union.
I didn't have contact with anybody from the Soviet government until September of 85, when I walked into the embassy in Helsinki. If you look at the Ames case, you'll see that it was shown that Mr. Ames started receiving money in the spring of that year.
If he didn't commit espionage, then the question is, why did he flee the United States at that time?
I acted like an intelligence professional. You know, I was trained that when you're faced with an intelligence threat, you react in certain ways, you get out. And I really didn't sit down and examine it calmly and say, I'm clean, it'll take time, and maybe I'll suffer, I'll lose my job, I'll spend a couple of years in jail, but you'll be okay. No. But I came here, and that's spilt milk.
Yuri Kobylatse is spokesman for the new Russian KGB.
There has been some speculation that some of the intelligence matters that Mr. Howard was, that were attributed to Mr. Howard, actually could be blamed on Aldrich Ames.
Exactly. You know that I'm not commenting on Mr. Ames' case, but yes, you're right.
Saying some things that were that Mr. Howard was blamed for actually should be blamed on Mr. Ames?
No, I can't comment on that, but your assumption is, I think, has certain ground.
A lot of the initial things that we thought maybe that Ed Howard had done, now we know that Mr. Ames was good for. So. In a lot of ways, it's helped our investigation.
Does the knowledge of Aldrich Ames take Ed Howard off the hook?
No.
I think that both Howard and Ames were responsible for deaths, serious intelligence lapses. Ames was a much bigger fish. Howard was a lesser fish, but nonetheless caused enormous damage at a time when the Soviet Union was still hostile, was still actively spying on us, and there were a lot of national security interests at stake.
There is no hard evidence and no confession, nor will there ever be a confession or hard evidence of my cooperating, giving national defense information to a foreign power. And nobody today has ever yet come up with that. Everybody talks, everybody writes, everybody makes allegations, but where is the meat?
Tomorrow night, Life on the Run for a Fugitive Spy. Larry Barker for Target 7.